I will just close my eyes and
wow, and off to sleep. So how many of you really want to sleep now? Tired of taking
me.
Okay. See, rest. Everybody is so rest. Everyone is so active in the class. Renshe, you did not have a good sleep last night. It means
yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I was studying till 12 and I had to wake up at 5.
Oh my God! Why at 5 to attend the classes at 8 in the morning? Why do you need to wake up at 5?
Ma'am, just like that, I couldn't sleep.
Oh my God. Okay. Renshe, you are a new admission. Or you're an old student?
Ma'am, I'm a new admission and joined this year only.
This year only. Even Sahil Khan is a new admission. Is that right, Sahil?
Yes.
Yes. Any other new admission? This super glow girl. Who is this super glow girl?
Ma'am, Manreena.
Manreena. So can we please have your name? Yes, that's true that you are glowing a lot. Yes.
Ma'am, is it fine?
Yeah.
Ma'am,
yeah.
I'm also a new admission.
Yes, you're also a new admission. So we have 3 new admissions in this class. Very nice. Okay, so let's begin our class today. Everybody open up your books to page number 65. Who is going to read out the chapter?
Sorry, ma'am, I have to turn off video off.
You don't know what?
Ma'am, I have to turn the video off.
Okay, now you put it on, no problem. Have you all opened up your books to page number 65?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Ma'am. So let's start doing this chapter. Let's begin our syllabus from the beginning. I want all of you to keep your copies along with you, your notebooks and your pens ready, because we are going to write a few basic rules of French language. We are going to learn the basics through this chapter.
So ma'am, please, can you wait a minute?
Yes. Everybody, those who haven't got their copies alongside, please go and get. And Tanu Patel and Shivesh, please put your videos on. Otherwise, beta, I won't mark you present. You actually have to
I'm
be
only
present.
7 students.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, only 5 students are present in the class because I'm just going to count the ones who have put their videos on. I am not counting Patel and Shivesh in. We only have 5 students. Ranshir, Sahil, Avnish, Manreena and Ayush Agarwal. Have I missed out anybody?
No, ma'am.
Good. So let's begin our class in another 2-3 minutes. If you are not putting your videos on, I'm sorry to say, but Tanu Patel and Shivesh, you will be removed from the class. I'm going to remove you from the meeting. Is Manreena back? She went to take her copy. Very nice, Tanu Patel. Good. This is how you're supposed to attend your online class with your video on. And Shivesh, last call. Okay, what is the name of the chapter, children? What is the name?
One second, I'll just come. My house bell is ringing. I'm alone at house.
Ma'am, this one chapter is completed.
Yes, it is completed. I'm saying that we are going to restart our syllabus so that those children whose concepts were not clear with those videos and WhatsApp classes can make their concepts clear now.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, now Shivesh and Tanu are present in the class. Then Now everybody is ready. Shall
we
start?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the name of the chapter? Who is going to read the name of the chapter? The name of the chapter is Les Amis de Caroline.
Les Amis de Caroline.
And that's Lesson 6. Lesson 6, Les Amis de Caroline. Now, what is Les Amis? Les Amis is the friends. What does Les Amis? Everybody write down the translation of each and every word. Les Amis. Les stands for L-E-S. If we individually pronounce this word, the pronunciation is Les. Why? Because rule number one of French is that if there are consonants that lie in the end of any word, if there is a consonant at the end of any word, we do not give it its sound. That is why we don't call it lace, we call it lay. If I want to say lay, if I want to say the girls, what is a girl in French? Girl in French is fille. If I want to say the boys, boys in French is garçon. So if I want to say the boys, I will say les garçons. I won't say les garçons. Les garçons is wrong. What is the pronunciation of L-E-S?
Les garçons.
Les. It's les. Now, here in the chapter, this word les is being followed by another word that is being started with a vowel. What does Ami start with? Ami starts with alphabet A. Alphabet A is a vowel in French also. So here in this case, we carry forward the sound of alphabet S along with the alphabet A. That is why we call it Les Amis. Clear? This is called liaison. We call it liaison when we carry forward the sound of the consonant with the sound of the vowel of the following word. If I have to say the girls, I will say les filles. The boys, les garçons. But if any word is starting with a vowel, I will carry forward the sound of the consonant. Les amis.
Okay,
les hommes. Homme, what is homme? H-O-M-M-E. That means a man. Now, even alphabet H is treated as a vowel in French. So we call it les hommes. Les amis. The chapter name is Les Amis de Caroline. Now, the friends of Caroline. We are going to talk about the friends of Caroline in this chapter. Now see children, what is Caroline? Caroline is a name of a girl. All of you know that names are considered as proper nouns, right? So another rule that comes is, another rule, before proper nouns, if we want to use if we want to use of or from, the word of and from, we put the, D-E. Suppose I say the pen of Neha. What is it? The pen of Neha. So what will I use in place of? Le stylo de Neha. What will I use? Le stylo de Neha. Which if we translate becomes the pen of Neha. Is it correct?
Yes,
but
ma'am.
If I want to say the pen of the girl, the pen of a girl, so what will I say? Le stylo de la fille. See, I'm typing in the chat box. Everybody see from there. Le stylo, the Neha. Neha is a proper noun, so we put the before it. But if we are using a common noun, what are common nouns? Like boy, girl, anything, school, any place, anything. Then it would be le stylo, the la ki. We put la in that case. But let's just talk about, if I say the pen of boy, of the boy. Le stylo du garçon. Of becomes du here. Let's just ignore the la and du. Let's only keep ourselves to the right now. The comes before proper nouns. The stands for, everybody write. The stands for of and from. Suppose I want to say, I am from Jaipur. Je suis de Jaipur. See, I am from Jaipur. Je suis de Jaipur. Jaipur is again a proper noun. And the sentence literally translated in English means I am from Jaipur. So we again put the in this case. The friends of Caroline. Les amis de Caroline. Clear the concept of the?
Yes, ma'am.
Good.
Yes, ma'am.
Very nice. Now written everything. Have you written all this? That is in the chat box. You have to write it in your copies, children, to maintain these notes.
Ma'am, I'm having these all.
Very nice. But please don't miss anything. Even if you have it before, you can please write them again. This is only going to help you out in the future. Then, let's come on to the first dialogue of this chapter. Now, let's study about the friends of Caroline. The first is, La, say Samira. What does la mean? Any one of you can tell me?
Da.
Yes, Manreena?
She.
Da.
Okay. Anybody else?
Ma'am, da.
Da. Anybody else?
Deoja.
What is the meaning of the first word of the chapter? That is la. Say Samira.
Ma'am, dear.
Yes. Now see, in the chat box I have typed. La means the, le means the. But this la which has an accent over it. Can you see a small comma kind of a sign?
Yes, ma'am.
On alphabet A?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
So that changes the meaning of the word. It is not... The word, this word here does not mean the meaning changes. La with an accent grave. This symbol is called accent grave. This means there. Everybody write. La with an accent grave means there. T-H-E-R-E. Om Saraswat, you want to be marked?
Ma'am, it will be there is Samira.
Yes? What are you saying? Sahil, I can't get you. You have to repeat.
Ma'am, the sentence will be, there is Samira.
Yes. There. This is Samira. Okay? Or there. It is Samira. Like that. Then, we have L.A. Pakistanis. Now, they are talking about their nationality. They are talking about Samira's nationality. Caroline is talking about Samira's nationality. What nationality is Samira, children?
Pakistan.
Pakistani. She is Pakistani. Then the next dialogue. Isi, say Pedro. Isi. What does Isi mean?
Yeah.
Here. Da means there. Isi means here. Here it is Pedro. Il e espanol. Now they are talking about Pedro's nationality, which is Spanish.
Spanish.
Now children, see, when we were talking about Samira's nationality, Pakistanese, we had put E in the end. And when we are talking about Pedro's nationality, we do not have any E in the end of espanol. So to change a nationality to feminine, what we do, we add an E in the end. Everybody write this rule. To change a nationality into feminine, we put E in the end. Written?
Yes, ma'am.
But this rule is not applicable in 100% cases. Now, what are the exceptions? Suppose there is a nationality that is already ending with E. We do not put another E to make it feminine. We leave it as it is. I am typing one example in the chat box. Now, I am talking about Swiss nationality. People living in Switzerland are Swiss. So, this word is already, Swiss is already ending in E. So, it comes in the similar form with feminine now, feminine gender also. Clear?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I am leaving from this phone. I will do from that phone.
Okay, beta. Okay, no problem. Clear? Everybody is clear about this concept? If there is
yes,
no,
ma'am.
If there is no E present, you have to add an E to make it feminine. If already an E exists, in the end, you don't have to add another E to make it feminine. Then, let's move on to the third dialogue. The third dialogue is, A wala, Sonia. Voila, Sonia. And there is Sonia. Like somebody enters the room and we say, and he is, and she is. Or you are introducing your friends to somebody. So how do you introduce? This is so-and-so, that is so-and-so, and this one. This is blah, 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 whatever. This is how you introduce. So that is how the introduction is taking place in this chapter. A voila. Now, what is A? E-T. What does E-T mean?
And
there is Sonia. L-A Italian. L-A Italian.
She is Italian.
She is Italian. Now, we are speaking about Italian nationality. Now, children, see, if we talk about a masculine Italian, here they are talking about a girl. If we talk about masculine Italian, then the spellings would be this. See in the chat box. Il e Italia. Now, we have not added E in the end. But what have we done to make it feminine? Look into your books. What is the dialogue? What are the spellings of Italian? Italian. E-double-N-E. To make it into feminine, the nationalities ending or the words ending in N with letter N or letter S. How do they get changed into feminine? We double up the consonant and add E in the end. That is why when they talk about Sonia, the spellings are Italian. Is that clear? We double up the consonant and add E in the end. One more example. Like we say bon and con. Bon is used for good and bon is also used for good, but it is used differently for both the genders. We have developed n in the end and added e. The concept is clear till here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now moving ahead to the dialogues of the chapter. Ekute e regarde. Listen and see. Now, Caroline, what does Caroline say? Salut, comment allez-vous? What is salut? Hi or hello? Comment allez-vous? What does comment allez-vous mean?
How are you?
So, Samira, Pedro, and Sonia, ensemble. What is ensemble? Together. Three of them together reply, très bien. What do they reply?
Very good.
Very good.
Very good. Caroline says, j'ai une question.
I have a question.
Now, children, what is this word, une? What is this word, une? Une stands for what?
Have.
No. What does une mean?
Is.
No.
Une.
Yes.
Dependent one.
Yes. I have a question. I have one question. This is what an indefinite article. I have a question. Okay, and it also stands for number one. Like here it means I have one question. Now, question yes, is feminine in gender. That is why they have put une question. See in the chat box, une question. Now, if number one or a has to be used before, Mandrina, please mute yourself. If it has to be used before something that is masculine. So what are we going to use? Suppose I say a boy. Boy is what? Masculine. So it will be un garçon. If I say a pen, it is going to be un stylo. Do you see the difference? Before feminine things, we use une. And before masculine, we use un. Everybody speak.
And you.
Ranshir.
And you.
Better, you are still muted. Unmute yourself and speak.
Ma'am, your video is paused.
My video is paused. Probably there is some issue from your side, Beta.
No, ma'am.
Ma'am, I can send you the screenshot.
Yes, Beta, there must be some problem at your end because all other students ma'am, can see me talking.
Can rejoin it?
Yes, rejoin it. Rejoin.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, Mandrina, how do you say and eun? Speak. And Yoon. Mandrina, unmute yourself and speak.
And Yoon.
Very good. Yoon is used before what? Yoon is used before feminine nouns.
Feminine.
And is used before?
Masculine.
Masculine nouns. Very nice. Now, moving ahead, Caroline says, J'ai une question. So, Samira replies, Qu'est-ce que c'est?
What is this?
What is the question? Then Caroline asks, Tu as le livre de français? You have the book of French. What is the question? You have the book of French. Now see, they are talking about a particular subject. Français here again is a proper noun. So what have they put? They have put the before it. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Tu as. Now what is tu as? Tu as means you have. you have the book of French.
French.
Then Samira replies, we. We means?
Yes.
Yes. J'ai le livre de français et de maths. I have the book of French and of maths. Right. Clear till here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Sonia says, Pedro, qu'est-ce que c'est? Now, Pedro has something in his hand. So, Sonia asks Pedro, qu'est-ce que c'est? What is it?
What is this?
Pedro replies, ce sont des fouilles pour le contrôle. These are the papers of the test, of the exam. Now, children, when I say, c'est un stylo, I am talking about one pen. This is a pen. Now, when I talk about many, when I talk about more than one, my sentence in English becomes? In English, what is it?
I have many pens.
Yes. This is a pen. These are pens. These are pens.
Pens.
Now, we have changed this is to these are. Similarly, in French, when I say c'est un stylo and I have to say these are pens, I will say ce sont des stylos. C'est changes to ce sont. Un changes to they, D-E-S. Ce sont des stylos. Okay, now change this sentence. C'est un livre. C'est un livre. What is the plural of c'est un livre? Tell me.
C'est un livre.
What?
Son tarifs.
Ce sont des livres. Yes. We will change. C'est un livre becomes ce sont des livres. Is it fine?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Then, moving ahead, ce sont des fouilles pour le contrôle. These are the papers of the exam. Then Sonia replies, oh la la, nous avons le contrôle aujourd'hui. Oh my, my, we have the exam today. Now Sonia is surprised to realize that she has an exam today. Oh my, my, we have an exam today. What is aujourd'hui? Aujourd'hui, what does it mean?
Today.
Yes?
Today.
Today. Aujourd'hui today. Means today.
Today.
Nous avons means we have.
We have.
We have the exam today. Clear?
Yes,
the chapter is clear to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
So how many things have we learned in this chapter? We have learned the concept of the. The comes before what? Proper nouns.
Noun.
The stands for of and from.
From.
Then children, we have the second rule that we studied was, what rule did we study? To make a noun into feminine, we add e in the end, right?
E in the end.
Ma'am, in
exception. To make anything into feminine, we add e in the end. Now, to it is not applicable in all the cases if there already exists an E. We do not add another E. Correct? And if any noun ends in N and letter S, to make it into feminine, we double up the consonant and add E in the end. Like, for example, in bon and bon. Clear? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Yes, ma'am. If there is any doubt, children, please let me know. I'm going to explain you, re-explain you the concept. Okay. Then another rule that we studied is, for feminine things, if we want to use a, we use yun. And for masculine, we use a. Yun question, yun fee. Un garçon, un stylo. Correct? Then, if our sentence is, this is a pen, this is, say. Say becomes ce sont. Say becomes ce sont in plural. Okay. And also, one more thing that we studied was la. If la has got accent grave on it, it means there. If it does not have any accent grave, it means the. It stands for the. Clear till here?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Then we have...
Yes, ma'am.
Just a second. Okay, Ranshir is saying that he joined the meeting and it automatically made him leave. All right. Then, now let's come on to the question answers. Turn the page, page number 66. Deet Re U Fo. Deet Re U Fo. What is Re U Fo?
True and false.
True or false. Now read out the first one. Ayush, read out the first sentence.
Pedro, Caroline, et Samira, son de Amy.
Deep. Tell. Tell me.
Pedro, Caroline, et Samira, son de Amy.
Yes, beta, it's Re U Fo. Is it true or false?
True.
True. Then Re. if it's true, yes, you say Re.
Re.
Good. Then Samira a le livre d'histoire. Samira a. What does a mean here? Alphabet A. What does it mean?
Have.
Samira has the book of French. So, no. Four. Then the next one. Sonia a Italian. Sonia a Italian?
Ray.
Ray. Very good. Pedro a Francais.
Four.
Bye-bye. First, Pedro a Espanol. Now, what is because in French? Because in French is past. I'm typing in the chat box. Okay. See, what does past mean? Past means because. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now let's come on to the definite articles. Yes. Yes, Manreena, past means because. Now, what are definite articles? When we talk about something definite, we know that what we are talking about, we are talking about a specified or a specific group of thing or specific anything, singular also. Like suppose if I say, there is a girl under the tree. There is a girl under the tree. I'm talking about something indefinite. There are a few girls under the tree. I'm not talking about anything in particular. I'm not talking about anything definite. I'm just randomly making a statement that there are a few girls or there is a girl standing under the tree. Now, if my statement changes to the girl standing under the tree is my sister. The girl standing under the tree is my teacher. Then that means I am talking about something specific. Isn't it? So whenever we talk about something specific, something definite, we use these definite articles. Like, see, if you turn the page to again page number 65, you will see Caroline's dialogue, dialogue number 3. Tu as le livre de français. Now she's talking about, she's asking about a particular book. You have the book of French. She's talking about something specific. That is why she has put this definite article before the word book. If I say this is a book, this is a book. It is not, I'm not talking about anything particular. Just a something that is indefinite. I will say, c'est un livre, un livre. Now this is the book of Neha. C'est le livre de Neha. This is the book of Neha. That becomes definite. So wherever we use definite article, we put le and la, which means the. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Then, yes, ma'am.
Let's come on to the table. Now, what is this word the in for masculine and for feminine? Then we have, how do we use this the? We use it in different forms for feminine and masculine nouns. Whenever it has to be placed before masculine words, we put L-E, right? And whenever we have to use it before the feminine nouns, we make it la. But this le and la changes before the plural nouns. If the noun is masculine or it's feminine, but it is in plural form, we simply